Thank you, Madam Speaker, and fellow members. I had a real problem with this when it was brought through committee, and the reason being is that I am a strong local control advocate. Quite honestly, I don't see why we have a Department of Housing and Community Development in the state of California, because it should be local control. That being said, I was forced to do a lot of work on this bill to find out what it did and did not do, because I support my local people and I support my cities, and it is their right to institute their codes and their land use. That is their jurisdiction, is land use. So the state really has no business here at all. But that being said, we do have a department, and we are dealing with property rights issue here and a local control issue all at once. The first thing I would like to say is I came from a city that was not, while not under rent control, did actually close a park. And because of rent control and because of what's happened in parks and how long it takes to do something, do anything with them, quite honestly, our people in our city were left with nowhere to move except Hemet. And that's from Dana Point to Hemet. We had people moving to Apple Valley and to Hemet. And it was just, it was a catastrophe. And the reason that it was so is because no one wants to invest in mobile home parks. So I had to do some serious research. On this bill, I think that Mr. Calderon overstates the amount of the amount that the property can appreciate. It's the lesser of two areas. It's either 100% of the existing rate over the next 7 years, and that doesn't begin until 2011. So if anyone has their house on the market right now to be sold, it does not take effect, does not affect that property. If somebody buys it before 2011, it is still under the local rent control. Then the second part, it's the lesser of the market value or 100% of the rent. I know in one of my units in our areas in Oceanside, they have a rent of $350 a month. Now, mind you, if this can maximally increase to 100%, that would be over the next years could possibly go to $700 and then fall under local rent control again. That's a heck of a deal for anybody. So I was torn with this because their option, if we don't do something, we will lose all of our available mobile home parks, because the option is the parks close, of which I have one in Oceanside that is closing, 54 units, and it's turning to vacant land. The mortgages on those coaches will be due at the time of closure. We also had that experience in Dana Point, where the people couldn't move their mobile home. They had mortgages about $200,000 on these units, and the mortgages were still due and payable with nowhere to go, because the lenders had actually made loans against leased property, or actually not even leased, but month-to-month rental property. Now that's a lender's issue. If you don't ever make your loan longer than the lease. And if you're on a month-to-month lease in a mobile home park, why a lender would loan against the land, I have no idea. But they put my people in Dana Point in a terrible position, because once that park closed, they were still obligated for that mortgage. So there was really no value to them anymore in what they owned, and they still owned the mortgage. They did not get relief, and they had nowhere to live. So I had to come down in support of this simply because I believe in the long term it will help people to have more affordable housing and options when the landowner at some point decides to sell the land. And so I supported this, and I really do believe that the state should get out of housing. These are and land use. This is local control issue. But that being said, this also speaks to property rights and the ability, and really in fairness to the mobile home owners, that they get some protection under the law. Thank you.
Mr. Amiano.